Today we're going to talk about how to calibrate your A4988. It's a pretty simple process. I'll walk you through it step by step. First of all, what I've found so far is that a NEMA 17 and a NEMA 11 calibrate just fine, but apparently a NEMA 23 I'm unable to calibrate because it is unable to get up to a high enough power level on the A4988. So I'm only going to show you how to do the NEMA 17, and I'll leave out the NEMA 11 so that you can figure that out on your own. So in a moment, I'll show you a little bit of detail about what we need to do for steps, and we'll go from there. Okay, the first step to do this is we need to remove the stepper driver from our board. Next, what we want to do is take all the jumpers out. Okay, now that we have it prepared, we're going to reinsert the stepper driver. Remember, the E is over here for enable, as well as the enable over here. So your potentiometer is facing away from the power in this particular board configuration. So in a moment, I'll show you a little bit more detail. Okay, I've taken the A4988 out so that you can see it. Now, over here, we're looking for a resistor value of R100 on this particular board. It's relevant for the surface mount resistor right here, and that will give us the value that we need for our equation later, so keep track of that because it may vary on your board, but about 95% of these are the same. So in a moment, I'll show you how to calculate your stepper value. Okay, this is the data sheet for the A4988. It explains a little bit about how it operates. So I strongly encourage that you read it. I'll leave a link in the description, but I'm going to show you a couple quick things here. The equation that we're looking for is really deep in the document, so we're coming up on it right about now. Here it is. So here's the equation that we're looking for. I'll let you read this on your own time to keep the video nice and short. And then down below, there's a chart that helps you select the right value, which is right here. So here's the value we're looking for. So in a second, I'll actually show you what the equation is that I worked out, and if you see any issues, let me know and I'll correct it. So in a moment, I'll show you how to actually see how the motor is selected for the actual power and how you can use that to compute your equation as well. Okay, here's the actual motor that I ordered for it. Now you're probably going to need a heat sink for this one. So down below, the value that we're looking for is the rated current. In this case, it's kind of high. It's 2.0 amps. And in a second, I'll actually show you what the equation looks like that we're going to use to calibrate. Okay, so here's the equation that I was able to work out. It's called VREF. And then we have our max motor current. We have that multiplied by, in parens, 8 times the resistor value times 71 for a fractional value. So what it works out to is we know that the motor max is 2. So we're going to multiply that by what's in the parens of 8 times 0.1 times 0.7. And then we're going to get our VREF value. So I know that part of it is 0.56, and then it's times 2. So we come up with 112. So it's 1.12 is our value for volts. So in a moment, I'll show you how to calibrate it on the MKS Gen L board. Okay, in order to calibrate, we have to set up our positive end on our multimeter with an alligator clip. So we're going to put an alligator clip on one end, place this over here, take the other end of the alligator clip, and clip it right here. And we're going to use that to adjust the trim pod, either left or right, to get the right actual calibration. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our serial USB and connect the big side to the board and the other side to the computer. This will provide enough power for us to measure. Then we'll take our potentiometer in a second and adjust it, but first we have to set the voltage. So on my multimeter, I have it set to voltage. Now I'm moving over the decimal point on mine to where I get 3 significant digits, because we want to get to 1.12. So you're going to take the ground end and put it on your USB serial connection. You're going to take the other end and place it in the trim pod. And now you're going to turn this. If you turn right, it will go down to the value that you want, up to the value you want, which is 1.2. 1.12. So keep turning left until you get there. Now turning right a little bit. Okay, that's close enough. So the next step is to remove the power for your USB. Remove your cable completely. You're then going to take out your A4988, and you're going to put back in your jumpers now that you're complete. And now you're going to place your A4988 back in, keeping in mind that you want to have the enable pin and the enable pin on your board matching, so your trim pod is facing away from your power. And now we're going to connect the power cable to your board. So on this particular board, it's positive in here and negative in here. You're going to tighten those down. Keep in mind the power is off. Now what you want to do is you want to reconnect to your serial USB cable. To your 3D printer board and the other end to your computer in just a second. But first we want to connect our stepper motor. Okay. And now connect the serial USB. Keep in mind you don't want to touch this area. Now I'm going to connect the power for the board, and in a moment I'll show you how to test it in Pronterface. Okay, the first thing we want to do is open up Pronterface. We want to connect to our device. and we're going to move the axis 100. Now note the noise level when it moves. Now when we move it back, the noise level is exactly the same. Now keep in mind, if you're unable to use a multimeter to calibrate it, you can always do it stepwise with the potentiometer or the trim pod, but you have to do it in increments, power everything off, and then listen for the sound that is like this. That's what you're aiming for. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.